Every second, a single jet engine swallows more air than you breathe in an entire day. That air is squeezed to pressures 40 times greater than the atmosphere and heated beyond 1,500 degrees Celsius, hotter than volcanic lava. It's then blasted out at nearly the speed of sound, enough thrust to lift hundreds of tons of metal into the sky. Think of a jet engine as a four-part symphony: intake, compression, combustion, exhaust. At around 1,000 kilometers per h, a turbofan can gulp over 1.2 tons of air per second, the weight of a small car. Multi-stage compressors then squeeze that air. By the final stage, the pressure can reach about 40 bars, like being 400 meters underwater. High pressure packs oxygen molecules tightly. The engine's fuel has more to burn. Fuel injectors spray a fine mist. It burns continuously. A controlled blowtorch inside the chamber. Turbine inlet temperatures can reach 1,700 degrees Celsius, but advanced nickel alloys, ceramic coatings, and clever cooling keep parts from melting. The hot, expanding gases spin the turbines, which drive the compressors, extracting just enough energy to keep the cycle going. Finally, the gases exit through the nozzle, turned into a focused, often supersonic jet stream that propels the plane forward. Every second, a Boeing 777's GE90 can produce roughly 115,000 pounds of thrust, the power of about 2,000 family cars. Jet engines don't just make planes fly, they bend the rules of physics. Turbojet, the raw speed demon. Simple, all hot gas, pure thrust. It shines above Mach 1. Concorde's Olympus 593 let it cruise at Mach 2 for hours, but turbojets are noisy and fuel-hungry at subsonic speeds. Turbofan, today's standard. Large fans move bypass air alongside the hot core. A high bypass ratio, 10, one in some modern designs, is what makes them quieter and 30-40% more fuel efficient. Example, the Rolls-Royce Trent XWB powering the Airbus A350, optimized for long-range efficiency. Ramjet, no turbines, no compressors. At Mach 2 plus, the aircraft rams air into the chamber and you get thrust with fewer moving parts. Scramjet, supersonic combustion ramjet, air stays supersonic inside the engine. Works only at extreme speeds. Each engine type lives in a different speed zone, from subsonic efficiency to hypersonic raw power, from the quiet efficiency under our airports to the furious heat of supersonic and beyond. Engineers pick the right tool for the speed. Flameout. If airflow is disrupted by turbulence, ash, or heavy rain, the fire can go out and thrust vanishes. Pilots or FADEC systems can restart engines, using igniters or windmilling the turbine to spin it back up. A 4 kg goose at high speed hits like a cannon. Bird strikes can shatter blades. Think US Airways 1549, the miracle on the Hudson. Icing. Fine ice crystals can choke airflow at altitude. Heated bleed air systems prevent buildup. Compressor stalls and surges occur when airflow breaks down. The engine coughs, bangs, or spits, flames out the intake. Modern FADEC systems sense anomalies and adjust fuel and airflow instantly to prevent damage. On takeoff, high bypass turbofans give maximum thrust and quiet the cabin for passengers. On cruise, efficiency rules. Bypass airflow saves tons of fuel on long flights. At Mach 2, turbojets and specific designs shine. For Mach 5 plus, scramjets enter the conversation. Future combined cycle engines promise seamless transition from runway thrust to hypersonic speed. A jet engine is a tuned explosion running thousands of times per minute, steady enough to carry millions.